Santa. So what are you saying, Todd?
Yeah, it's your dog stealing this motherfucker for the 9-6. Like this.
Here comes a hog with the big nuts. Big nuts. He's flowing like a breeze.
I said,
here comes a hog with the big nuts. Big nuts.
And it's flowing like a breeze.
This ain't Halloween, ain't no trick or treat. You young silly assholes can't get shit for free. I give a fuck about what niggas been buying you. I'm short dog, bitch, I ain't trying to get on your bitch side. You better get with me so we can roll in luxury around the world. Getting money, I'm pimping hoes on Sunday. I'm the kind of nigga that you work all night for. Won't discriminate, I pimp a Chinese white hoe. You never seen money with a black man's face. But I swear, motherfucker, I done had my taste. Can't slow down, full speed ahead. I'm laughing at you square, saying pimping is dead. They say sex can kill, you catch AIDS and shit. But the facts stand, hoes get paid for tricks.
I never let a hoe tell me. I never let her hold. Tell me.
And I'm a hoe, say.
I never ever be pimped again. I had to be played once to really understand, but I appreciate it. Short, cause I related. I polished up my game and participated. Got baptized. It wasn't a dream. Now I'm acting with the dangerous crew and smoking green. Hit old school players up on the hip, and we all decided to take a trip. We on the world tour, checking our clientele. Want to see how much pussy these hoes sell. Feds say this crew is scandalous. Want to charge us off of pimping and pandering. From Mississippi Valley to the ATL to Chattown, Oakland, these bitches will understand. P.I. to the D.I.E. Ha ha, you never pimp me.
I never let her go.
And all my hoes say,
Snake Cap. Yeah, what's going on, Sir Charles?
Man, whatever happened to that great big fine bitch you had the other day?
Yeah, that old bitch come to me the other day, man. Talk about she want to do her own. I knocked that bitch down, man. I asked that bitch, what part did you understand, bitch? Because I don't understand none of it. Ho? Well, you was a hoe to me, bitch. You don't stay a ho, ho, ho?
So what you said, you'll never let a bitch help you, man.
Never, man. Hey, Sir Charles, what about that little expensive bra I was seeing the day you with it? Look, you the little girl.
Oh, you talking about you meet my little bitty bitch.
Yeah, she's that little expensive looking girl. She look kind of fine to me.
Man, that girl went to work the other night and bought me $999 out of the street.
You gone, boy.
She asked me would I loan her $10 so she could give me a grand. I said, yeah, she got to be crazy. Go to another date and put my money in my motherfucking hand.
Oh, man, ain't never giving that to
me. This ain't no joke. I've never let a bitch pimp me.
Never, never.
Say, hey, man, you know we ride with this dangerous crew.
Oh, yeah, with those shouts. You know, you good for the pimp.
Yes, yes, the Reaper. We back in the green room again. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper because I'm doing good things here at Reaper, man. All right, let's get to the topic. Corey Holcomb. I'm talking to you, Corey Holcomb. Call your sewer rat off the Reaper. You know, I'm just being real because your sewer rat has been trying to contact the Reaper, right? And just because you pay for pussy, that don't mean everybody else do. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. I mean, this broad can't even sell, you know, no pussy, right? I'm just being honest. She need to stop letting these niggas at the welfare office and on probation tell her she look good. Because only a desperate nigga would be with a sewer rat like this. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Man, the worst thing that ever happened to a broad, man, is the internet. The Reaper always say that. The internet done messed up a many a family, man. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because it puts a broad in fantasy, man. I mean, some of these broads that come from the mean streets, the internet will make them think they can go up to the Emory Suites, man. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest about it, man. They'll come from the projects and think they, you know, got money to drive Learjets. The Reaper keep it 1,000. But, you know, hey, man, this is what the internet do, man. And what the Reaper do, I'll blow a broad fuse and put her up under some new rules, man. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'll make her choose and put her up under some new rules. Because you know what? I have a meal plan for a broad. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Ain't nobody had no meal plan for this broad. This broad talking about she fine and all of this, that, and the other. But ain't nobody had no meal plan for this broad. You know, if you can't even, you know, you don't even have $300, right? And you a broad, right? I mean, you know, your pussy ain't worth shit. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And all these broads got all of these myomectomies and mectomies pussy running around here because they done let, you know, every Tom, Dick, and Harry jump up in that ass, man. The Reaper keep it 1,000 so the ass is woe out. I mean, I bet you this broad has never had a boss. And she's trying to talk to a boss, you know, saying, I wouldn't give you a second look. I know you wouldn't because the Reaper is a boss and a productive nigga. You know, all you done had street niggas. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. I mean, without any paper, broad, the Reaper keep it 1,000. Where is the paper at, broad, that you asking Corey for $300 and you don't even know him? You know, where is it at? Where is your productivity at? I mean, what do you do, broad, to bring in some money? I mean, niggas is running 72 cutlasses up through your house, right? And still sleeping in the house, you know, after they run the 72 cutlass up in there. You know, you see the hood of the car in the living room and they still be walking around cooking chicken. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest about it because she has no tact. I'm just being honest. This broad has no tact and the internet, what it'll do, man, because the Reaper always have a teachable moment, right? What the internet do with these broads, they had these desperate niggas, right? I'm just being honest. And they be contacting these broads, right? And they be telling them that they look good, they fine, they everything like that. But when they look at their situation in reality, right? You can't even get $300. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. A nigga will not take you across the street. You know, this is what I'm saying, you know, unless you pay for it. But this is what the internet do, man, you know, to these desperate broads, right? I thought the broad was a man. You know, I mean, they'll have these broads that shaped like a rhino and Henrietta Hippo, right? With big titties and shaped like a rhino, right? Thinking they look good. I'm just being honest, man. The internet has tore up so many families, man, and put so many broads in fantasy, man. You know, you asked all the players out there. They say, what's the new drug out here? They say the internet. They say it because it puts a broad in fantasy, right? I mean, it makes a broad think that she could pull a boss or something like that. Or I wouldn't look twice at a boss or I could pull a boss, right? You can't even pull a boss. You know, Corey thought I was attractive enough to get wet or whatever. Niggas will tell you anything, right? To get some head and some pussy hole. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because that's all you've been all your life. You know, if you don't have a nigga that's done cuffed you, I bet you this broad ain't never had a nigga that's done cuffed her that's productive. Because where is he? You know, I'm just being honest. Where is your nigga that's done cuffed you that's got, you know, some paper? You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, I look at Dee. Dee done had iced tea. She crossed the tracks. You know, I'm just saying. But she's never had a nigga since iced tea that's done cuffed her. Y'all know Corey cuffed her, but Corey ain't cuffing her like iced tea did. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest, because once you done been with a boss, you don't get a boss again. And a lot of these women can't get these niggas to cook them breakfast. They come over with a bottle of Hennessy, right? And they want to jump up and down in the ass, right? And leave, you know? And it ain't your nigga, you know? It's another woman's nigga. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I bet you, you know, this bra got babies by different niggas that's got babies all over the place. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest about it, you know? I guarantee you that this broad, that nigga that's got a baby by her, I bet you he got two or three or four broads pregnant out there. The Reaper keep it 1,000. This is how it be. I have never saw a fine broad in Detroit and the Reaper be all over the place. I've yet to see a fine broad in Detroit. I mean, I've been to New York, Frisco, L.A., the Reaper get around, right? I ain't saw a fine broad in Detroit. Hey, you saw a fine broad in Detroit? Where is the fine broad? I see some screw face broads walking around there, you know, trying to show off their ass, right? And the ass, you know, they be a size 20 or 22, and they be ass, their ass be big. The Reaper keep it 1,000, but I haven't saw a fine broad. This broad thinks she fine and ain't got nothing, ain't got used for nothing but ass. Her ass ain't even no good. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I mean, you know if your ass is good or not, right? Unless you wouldn't need $300, and she thought $300 was something. Because that's what she asked for, broad. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, I'm just being honest about it. And she thought that Corey was feeling her. He thought I was attractive enough. And when we looked at the Texas, right? She was contacting him more than he was contacting her. The Reaper keep it 1,000. She even went to Corey's show and he still didn't hook up with her. You know, I'm just being honest about it. Because see, let me tell you something, honey. I'm just going to be honest. Now, Corey messed with sewer rats, right? And I done told Corey he shouldn't be messing with sewer rats, but Corey messes with sewer rats because he be on the road, right? I'm going to tell you, this is what Corey wanted to use it for. Some head and some pussy hole. The Reaper keep it 1,000 when he came to town. He wasn't going to fly you nowhere. He wouldn't want to spend. He didn't even want to spend $300 on you. I'm just being honest about it. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because you can't get $300 because you still needed $300. And you got on TV, you got on the video and embarrassed yourself. This is what some women do. They will embarrass themselves. This broad is mentally ill. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Hey, you see these broads out here, man, they be mentally ill. They don't even know that they embarrassing themselves. You know, they'll get on, just like she got on GMS's show and said she needed $300 because somebody had ran their car up in her house, right? And you could tell it was ghetto by the light fixtures in there, right? Somebody had ran her, a car up in her house. What happened is, see, these broads from the hood, they be violent, man. They had these violent niggas, and the violent niggas say, open up the door, and she be fucking somebody else. Open up the fucking door, because he ain't got nowhere to live, you know? So he'll run the car up in there and go to jail. The Reaper keep it 1,000. This is what will happen, man. You know? You know a nigga ain't got no career when he run a car up into a broad's house. But this broad talking about who she would, let me just say, this is how the internet put these broads, you know, in fantasy, man. She talking about who she wouldn't look at twice. She can't even get a nigga to give her $300, but she talking about who she would look at twice. Like she fine, you know, because these niggas in the hood, right? With no careers or whatever is jumping up in that ass. You know, when I see a broad like that, you can see the struggle all on them. You know, and if you can see the struggle on a broad, right? I mean, I'm going to tell you something. And you a boss, you don't mess with that. Because that's going to be a problem, man. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because, you know, if you 50 years old and you ain't got $300, right? And you a broad, right? That's telling me something already. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You 50 years old, still getting on the internet, right? Saying that you needed $300 and niggas is running 72 cutlasses up in your house. And then you know she mentally ill. She never had no personal contact with Corey whatsoever, right? And then she said he R-worded her. Huh? This broad is mentally ill. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest about it. And you know why nobody never cut this broad. This broad ain't nothing but some ass and some potato chips. That's what she is. She's ass and potato chips. Nigga say, bring me that bag of Fritos over there after you hit that ass. Shit. He gonna make him a prison meal with ramen and Fritos. Shit. Reaper keep it 1,000. I mean, shit. I'm just being honest about it. And she's talking about bosses. You know, I'm going to tell you what these broads do, man. They try to make the hero, the hero, the zero, and the zero, the hero. And a lot of these goofy ass niggas believe these broads like this. These mentally ill broads. You know, if you a Midwest five, baby, because, you know, I mean, you a West Coast or East Coast too. The Reaper keep it 1,000 or one. or you don't even register on the Richter scale. This is what we see. See, bosses, we see fine broads from all over the place, you know, and you are not a fine broad. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, you need to cut that out. You know how you know you're not a fine broad? Look at your bank account. That's what tells you whether you a fine broad. Look at the niggas that you choosing. You know, I'm just being honest. You know, I mean, you can fuck a boss, and that's only if he desperate or whatever. But a boss is never going to cuff you. You're 50. The Reaper keep it 1,000. If you haven't been cuffed by now, you will never get cuffed. This is the reality of it. This is the teachable moment to you. You know what I'm saying? I mean, your pussy ain't worth $300. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Your pussy ain't worth a nigga. Have you ever had a trip with a nigga where you didn't have to, where he flew you out and that's your nigga? I bet you some of these bras ain't never had something that was they nigga. It's always been somebody else's nigga that's been hitting them. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Where is your nigga at 50, right? That's got some ends. You know when you ain't loved, right? Because you asking somebody that you know for $300 and thinking that's some money. And then say it ain't shit. Well, why did you ask for that much? How come you didn't ask for 3,000? Because if a nigga give you $300 to spend, oh, he done the world. And ain't no nigga even worth, ain't no nigga, you ain't even worth a nigga spending $300 on. I'm just being honest about it. I mean, hey, you take this bra to Denny's or Red Robin's and you got the ass. You know, you don't even have to do that. Nigga won't even take her out for a chicken finger meal, but she's trying to come at a boss. You know, this is what happens. She's talking about bosses and the nigga won't take her for a chicken finger meal. The Reaper keep it 1,000. This is the way some of these broads is. You know, I'm just saying, I could tell that you pay for your nigga and you ain't got enough money to pay for him. They only gonna get some dysfunctional nigga, man, to lay up with all the time. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest. They're going to get some dysfunctional ass nigga, you know, that spend 4 months with them and 8 months in the joint or running through jobs or this, that, and the other. This is the only type of nigga they're going to get. You know, they ain't used to, you know, traveling and flying and this, that, and the other. And a boss have a nice crib and, you know, cars and shit all around there. They ain't used to that shit, man. Reaper keep it 1,000. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being honest about it. That nigga had a 72 Cutlass that needed to be Z-barred it, that's rusted out. You can see the flow, you know, you can see the street. And he ran that motherfucker up and he saw the porch, you know, through his floorboard while he went through the front door. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And she know he wasn't gonna fix it, cause this is the type of niggas she deal with. The Reaper keep it 1,000. He ran up in that raggedy roach motel. Shit. The reason he was able to run up in there, you know, because the porch, she don't got no porch. He said he gonna drive that motherfucker right up in there. And the Midwest is flat land. He came right off the street and drove that motherfucker right up in the front, in the living room and shit. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And she gonna ask Corey to fix what her nigga done. Corey said, what that shit got to do with me? Well, send me some money, because you selling it anyway. You giving it to a nigga anyway. Shit, you giving it to a nigga that's got less than $300. Shit. She get in the car, shit. She put $10 worth of gas. If a nigga put $10 worth of gas in that motherfucker, shit, she happy. Guess what, girl? What? He bought over some chicken wings and a bottle of Hennessy, and he put $10 worth of gas in my car. Shoot, girl, you balling out of control. You got that nigga doing all that? I ain't even lying. You niggas need to quit selling these broads fantasy on the internet, man. Because you know what? It's fantasy because when they see their situation, you know what you're worth. That's why it's fantasy. It's not reality. It's not logic. When you see your situation, broad, you know what you're worth. You know what I'm saying? I mean, all you getting is fucked, literally, physically, and financially. The Reaper keep it 1,000 all the time. But you fail to realize that because you mentally ill. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I'm just being honest about it. You know? Now, everything the Reaper said is alleged on this program because I don't know this woman, but this woman contacted the Reaper, right? And left comments to the Reaper, you know, because she was disgruntled off of the videos I made. She can't even learn nothing off of the videos that I made. Like, bro, don't be this. Get your shit together. But it's too late for her, man. Ain't nobody cuffing that. You know, I'm just being honest about it. She'll live in the hood the rest of her life because she in fantasy. She thinks she talented and she look good, right? And she living in the hood and, you know, and she need $300. This is the fantasy mindset of some of these bras. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know, because if you was talented, bra, right? And you look good and you have some good cuda, well, a nigga would be done cuffed you. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. I'm just being honest about it. I thought it was a man. I thought it was a man on GMS when she's playing with that fake hair. I said, is this a man or a woman? Man with fake titties? Or is this... Huh? A nigga just want to get his nuts off, you know. Shit, he ain't even spending the night with that. He come over and get his nuts off. You know, that's a booty call, you know, where you come over all that stuff failed at 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, and you come over and get your nuts off. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. I'm just being honest. She done had a lot of undercover men go up in that because you could tell she messed with a lot of criminals. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I can tell. I can look at her and see the struggle. When you look at a broad man and she screw face and you see the struggle, I see a lot of screw face bras in the Midwest, man. And you see the struggle on them. I said, shit, it's not even appealing to the Reaper because if you ain't in a certain income bracket, bra, you know what I mean? I mean, you can't work at McDonald's, you know, or Ahab's up the street or Captain Jack's. You know, and be with the Reaper. The Reaper keep it 1,000. That's not appealing to me. You know, if you don't got no paper, you know, I mean, you could not even play with the Reaper. So you don't have to worry about looking at the Reaper because the Reaper wouldn't look at your broke ass. Reaper, we keep it rough. We keep it raw. We keep it real, man. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper because I'm doing good things here at Reaper. Reaper out. Peace.